MashaAllah, one of greatest book also for Tazkiya, for Tarbiyah, for MashaAllah, this book, very special book. In Tazkiya way, this is maybe the best book for Imam Nawawi. In Tazkiya way, this book, Bustaan al-Arifeen, is the best. Is the best book for Imam Nawawi. He have many books, but this book is special, mashallah. And who is this Imam? You know, most of you know Imam Nawawi. Mashallah is, mashallah, Allahu Akbar. Allah give him, subhanallah, Allah give him a good reputation. And most Muslim, they accept him. Maybe especially that book, Riyadh al-Salihin. Maybe all houses of Muslims, they have this book, mashallah. In our country, in Arab countries, maybe every masjid, every musalla, they should have Riyadh al-Salihin. And daily we read Riyadh al-Salihin, daily, in masjid and in house. You have Fadail al-A'mal. This Fadail al-A'mal, you mashallah, you read it many times. In Arab, Fadail al-A'mal is, they have some notes about Fadail al-A'mal, some mawdu, this. But Riyadh al-Salihin, Arab, they accept it. So you can imagine what label this person he have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah accept his books around the world. MashaAllah, yeah, monthly, daily, his books is boating, huh? And the persons they sell and buy, MashaAllah, especially Riyadh al-Salihin. Also many universities around the world, Islamic universities, Islamic institutes, they teach Riyadh al-Salihin. Allah Akbar. What secrets, brothers? If every one of us have a secret with Allah, Allah will achieve what your goal. Everyone have goals in his life. If you make secret with Allah, something between you and Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, Allah won't last that. He will Subhanahu wa Taala. Give you what you want, because to have a secret with Allah, this is not easy. To keep it secret with Allah only, then the inside, this called the nafs, he don't like that. What secrets this person he have with Allah? Until also some scholars, they did research about Imam Nawawi. What's his secrets, and they mentioned what I remember, one of his secrets also, his food only one bread daily. Can I imagine this? One bread daily only, and he wait for this food his father he sent to him daily. He don't eat from the plants of Dimashq. He don't eat from Dimashq. He don't eat. Why? Because most the lands of Dimashq is waqf. You know waqf in English? Sorry?
Endowment.
Endowment. Most of the lands, endowment. So he this is taqwa. This is the second secret. His taqwa is in high level. MashaAllah. His taqwa is very strong. His taqwa, so he don't maybe he prefer to stay hungry than he eat from the fruits and what come in the earth from the lands of Dimashq. And he only eat one bread daily. Second thing we mentioned taqwa, and also Third thing, also some scholars, they said of his secrets, he don't sleep at the night. He write his books, and at that time, he live from he start, he be scholar, and until he death, many books he write, and that books is not enough for that time. The scholars, they said, how he did write those old books, and his time is short. He didn't reach to 70 years or 65 years, Imam Nawawi. He died 45. His youth, he mashallah, he didn't also, this one of his secret, he didn't marry. He preferred to serve the knowledge all, and he give the knowledge all his time. When he was writing his books, they enter to his room, and he's lying at his books. Yeah, he be sleepy until beat him that's Allah Akbar, until he force him to sleep. Sometimes he spent 2 days without sleeping, just writing and lessons and here and there, subhanAllah. And also at the same time, he was having a good ibadah with Allah, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They mentioned also his tahajjud strong, and he was also reciting daily the Quran, many parts daily, and also many zikr. How he did all this? This is the meaning of the secret. When you have secret, Allah will give you barakah. So all scholars, they deal in one point. All of them, they said, Allah, he give him barakah. This is barakah. This is something from Allah. He did good worship. He did good da'wah. He did good ta'lim. He did, mashallah, he was doing good lessons. He write good books. And when he finished write Riyadh al-Salihin and his books, he put it in the roof. And he said, Ya Allah, if this books, I write it for you, please spread this books to the Muslim. If it's not for you, I don't want anyone to touch it or to give permission to reach this book to the others. And also, scholars, one scholar, I read about him, that when he died, he passed away, somebody, he saw him in his dream, and he asked him, what Allah, what happened with you? So he said, in my grave, Allah give me a lot of nur. So I asked Allah, Ya Allah, this nur, please put it in my books, and accept my books to be my books to reach to the to every Muslim. And you can see now his books around the world. Millions of books for Imam Nawawi. This is his life. What did he do? We know all, but what's the secret? How he in short time, mashallah, he did a lot of things, mashallah. And also some scholars, although they said the latest more barakah, Sheikh Muhammad, akhirul al-a'imma barakah, akhirul al-a'imma barakah, al-imam al-Nawawi. In English, you can say?
The seal or the last of the great imams.
The seal, the seal of the last of the great imam was Imam Nawawi. More barakah Allah give him, mashallah. Now, alhamdulillah, we start with his one of his books, the best also book in, mashallah, for tazkiyah, for brothers also. There is first in Quran, said in Quran. There is a first set. Allahu Akbar. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Huwa alladhi ba'atha fil ummiyina rasulan minhum yatlu alayhim ayatihi wa yuzakkihim wa yu'allimuhum al-kitaba wal hikma. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a passenger or not passenger, I mean
messenger.
Huh? Rasul, Rasul, Allah, he sent
messenger.
Messenger, Allah, he sent a messenger from you, Arab, from you, not from other community, from you, Arab. Why this messenger I sent him? To teach you my verses. Yatlu alayhim ayatihi. Tafsir ulama, they said, da'wah. This is da'wah. This is mean of da'wah. Because many, the most verses in Mecca was talking about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inside the hearts of the Sahaba in Mecca, those who get in Islam, inside their hearts is shirk of hubal. There is a lot of shirk. So Allah, he removed this shirk and cleaned their hearts from any makhluk, any reason, any action of makhluk, from others. He sent verses of the greatness of him, talking about him. You know, the Quran is 30 part, 20, around 20 part is talking about Allah subhanahu. 20 part is talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This 20 part in Mecca, all this 20 part where? Most, 95% of this 20 part in Mecca. So this 25, the tafsir ulama, they said, this is da'wah. Allah, he give them da'wah. Yatlu alayhim ayatihi. Muhammad, he mentioned his, you know, Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, he got to Islam because of Quran. So this is maqam, he mentioned maqamud da'wah level, then taskiyah level, then he said wa yu'allimuhum al-kitab wal hikmah. Wa yu'allimuhum al-kitab wal hikmah. Yu'allimuhum al-kitab wal hikmah, that mean he teach them the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some mufassirin, they said that. So this three levels, da'wah and tazkiyah and ta'lim, like this, and those three, who take care? Some mufassirin, tafsir, they said, who take care about this three points? Always he teach himself how he became da'i, and also at least he's da'i in his family, in his with his friend at least, and also at the same time how he take care about tazkiyah, and until he clean inside him, and also at the same time he take care about knowledge, Allah will make him one of those who revive the religion everywhere he go. You understand the point? You understand, brothers? Inshallah, you understand. سيجعله يجدد الدين أينما ذهب. He will give him power that he can revive the religion, the deen of the Islam, and over the religion of the Islam by nice way. And give him barakah, and give him hikmah from Allah. If he take care always about these three, also mufassirin, tafsir, ulama, they said this ayah mentioned four majlis in this ayah, and this yatlu alayhim ayatihi wa yuzakkihim wa yu'allimuhum al-kitab wal hikmah. Yatlu alayhim ayatihi. Majlis da'wah. Rasulullah, he was doing to Sahaba da'wah. Majlis, many circles of da'wah. Give them da'wah. Many circles. around in Mecca, how many times? 13 years in Mecca. And also he said وَيَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِي وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. And also مجلس قرآن, مجلس قرآن, sorry تزكيه مجلس ذكر. There is difference between مجلس دعوة. We cannot say this دعوة. This is not مجلس دعوة. مجلس دعوة, and the scholars they said, what mean مجلس دعوة? We talk only about Allah. We talk only about whom? This is دعوة إلى الله. دعوة إلى. Ibn al-Qayyim, he said that da'wah is three parts. Da'wah ila Allah, then da'wah to Quran, to the book of Allah, then da'wah to the sunnah, then da'wah to the sunnah. So he mentioned here this majlis dhikr, like this we can say this is majlis dhikr, majlis dhikr. This majlis dhikr, Rasulullah, he mentioned many hadith for majlis dhikr. And also here in Malaysia, they have also majlis dhikr different. They have majlis tahleel. They called it majlis tahleel. Every Thursday, they have a gathering in every surah, every masjid, you will see here in Malaysia. Yeah. And they all the persons inside the masjid or the surah, they recite Yasin. And after they recite Yasin, they say afdalu dhikr, la ilaha illa, then la ilaha illallah, la ilaha. This is called also majlis dhikr. So the majlis dhikr is two kinds. Majlis dhikr, we talk about Rasulullah, about it's about imaniyat, iman, about imaniyat, about we talk about sahaba. This we can say majlis dhikr. Also, and the other thing, tahleel without bad actions. You know, some of they do tahleel until they do, you know, who, oh, any, like this words, like that. Now, also, we mentioned majlis dhikr, tazkiyah. So, tazkiyah, maqamu tazkiyah, the level of tazkiyah is dhikr. This dhikr clean us from inside. And also, majlis Qur'an, the third thing. وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابِ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمْ الكتاب. This is what? Kitab. Scholars of tafsir, they said, is Quran. He teach them what inside the Quran. يسألونك عن الأنفال, يسألونك عن ال, explain to them Rasulullah what's the meaning. Also, ويعلموا الكتاب والحكمة. This is majlis ilm, the hikmah, Rasulullah, al-halal wal-haram. So for majlis, Rasulullah, he raised the sahaba by four majlis. Some scholars, they mentioned this four majlis. And some scholars they of tafsir, they mentioned this tafsir of ayah, 2-3, maqamu al-tazkiyah, maqamu al-da'wah, maqamu al-tazkiyah, maqamu al-ilm. By whatever, all this majlis or all this maqamat, who take care about those, be in schedule his life and have majlis ilm, majlis dhikr, majlis da'wa, majlis Quran, schedule his life, and he put day, for example, two times in a way, in with my family, I recite Quran. Together we recite Quran, teach each other. Two times in a week, in the week, I have two majlis ilm. One time in this with this color, one time this. Two time in a week, I have. If there is any majlis da'wah here or here, I enjoy them. If there is any majlis dhikr, I enjoy them. So If he always take care about these four things, or these three things, da'wah or tazkiyah or ilm, one day he will complete. One day Allah will complete him. Because the what called lack inside us, the lack inside me is different with my what inside you, you or others, huh? Everyone have lack, it's like that?
No.
Naqs, huh? Naqsun, huh?
No.
Yes.
Deficiency.
Yeah.
Deficiency.
Deficiency, huh? That deficiency inside me is different from you. And everyone have it. Deficiency, huh? Like that. Everyone have that. He must have some deficiency. So who knows exactly what's your deficiency? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you take care, if you move the same step, even if it's slowly, but you are moving the same step of the Sahaba, Allah will give you the same rewards Allah give Imam Nawawi. Give those. At least you will die and you are complete. Even if you don't have a book, will be famous around the world, at least you, Allah will complete your happiness, will complete your needs. You will complete Allah Akbar, your wife, your children. Will make your life more better. More better, less better, this is not you. You cannot control. You take reasons, but who will make your life better? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if we move at the system that Allah, He gives the Sahaba, the same system we move, by high sincerity, by our money, we don't want, by good intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one day He will complete us. This is what I remember from scholars, they said. And I was noting until now, many persons, they are, mashallah, successful, mashallah. Why? When I see, especially in religion way, why they are so, I see them. They are taking care about these three levels or these four majlis in their life. MashaAllah, they complete. So this is the secrets of the most famous and successful persons in Islamic, in our religion. This is their secrets. By this four or this three, the you will have a good taqwa, you will have a good iman, huh? You will have a strong speech. Allah will give you more effect. You will be more effect in your around everywhere you go. The people will everywhere. They will need your help, your guidance to guide them to the better. This is permission from whom? We take care what He want. He give us this prices, this rewards. This rewards. This is rewards from Allah. This is the main point, inshallah. We take care about that, inshallah. And the Imam Nawawi, one also of his secrets, mashallah, he was taking care about these three things. In da'wah, he was doing a good da'wah in his time. And tazkiyah, he's mashallah. Every person around him, they satisfy that his akhlaq is high akhlaq, mashallah. He didn't hurt anyone. He didn't, even when he do advice, he do by a nice way that people accept, or he don't talk. So in ta'lim, you know Imam Nawawi in ta'lim, mashallah. Huh? Mashallah. So inshallah, now we enter to the first chapter. Al-Ikhlas wa Ihdhar al-Niyya fi jami' al-A'mal al-Zahira wal-Batina. قال الله تعالى وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء ويقيموا الصلاة ويؤتوا الزكاة وذلك دين القيمة. معناه الملة المستقيمة وقيل القائمة بالحق والله أعلم. وقال تعالى ومن يخرج من بيته مهاجرا إلى الله ورسوله ثم يدرك الموت فقد وقع أجره على الله. وقال تعالى ربكم أعلم بما في نفوسكم. وقال تعالى لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم. وقال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما معناه ولكن يناله النيات منكم. وقال إبراهيم التقوى ما يراد به وجهه. وقال الإمام أبو الحسن الواحدي قال الزجاج المعنى لن يتقبل الله الدماء واللحوم إذا كانت من غير تقوى الله تعالى وإنما يتقبل منكم ما ستتقونه به. وهذا دليل على أن شيئا من العبادات لا يصح إلا بالنية وهو أن ينوي به التقرب إلى الله تعالى وأداء ما أمر به.
Chapter 1, Sincerity and Having a Conscience Intention in All Actions Inward and Outward. Allah says they were only ordered to worship Allah, making their deen sincerely His as people of pure natural belief, and to establish the prayer and pay zakat. That is the deen of uprightness. This means a straight system of worship. It is also said that it means based on the truth. Allah knows best. Allah says, if anyone leaves his home, immigrating to Allah and His Messenger, and death catches up with him, it is Allah who will reward him. Allah says, your Lord knows best what is in yourselves. Allah says, their flesh and blood does not reach Allah, but your taqwa does reach Him. Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, said, it means that your intentions reach Him. Ibrahim said, taqwa is the means by which you desire His face. Imam Abu Hassan al-Wahidi said that Az-Zajjaj said, the meaning of this is that Allah will not accept an offering of flesh and blood when it is done without fearful awareness of Allah. He accepts that through which you show Him your fearful awareness. This indicates that no act of worship is without intention. The intention is that you want to draw near to Allah and carry out His command.
Always, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sees what's inside this person. Inside everyone now in this lesson, Allah he see in our hearts. There is also a hadith mentioned, Allah he see every heart daily, every heart around the world daily. He see 7 times. There is hadith mentioned, Allah he see to every heart daily 70 times. He see your heart daily 70 times. So this is the meaning. The heart is difficult to fix him in one niyyah, in the same niyyah. That three niyyah, Shaykh Muhammad, he mentioned to us to fix our hearts in that niyyah until tomorrow. The heart will try to change. This is, you don't feel your heart. He changes slowly he change the niyyah. So Rasulullah Isa in correct hadith,
authentic
hadith, Rasulullah said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub, ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deenak. That's mean the heart is not easy to make it in one intention. Imam Shafi'i, the big challenge for me was facing the niyyah in every work. This is so there is you know, jama'at tabligh, jama'at, they have 6 points. I like in their six points one thing, tasheeh al niyyah. This they in the five points, it's called sifa al khamisa, tasheeh al niyyah. This is when I just think about this, Allahu Akbar. It's me. How we correct every time our intention. One of Sahaba, they said, in one work, I faced the niyyah 70 times. In one work. What's this speech? Why I'm talking now? I take care, mashallah, till they like me. There is a hadith mentioned in Ihya Ulum al-Din. It's not strong, but mentioned in Ihya Ulum al-Din, said, من تعلم العلم لأربع من تعلم العلم لأربع دخل النار. Those who learn the knowledge for four reasons, they will enter. There is four reasons. If we learn this knowledge for this four reason, we will enter to hell. وَالْعَيَادُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْعَيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. What's this four reasons? لِيُمَارِي بِهِ السُّفَهَا. Those bad persons in our community, I one day one of them he was discussed with me, and when he beat me in that discuss, so I went to my home, I take a book and about that point, take the book and look what's so tomorrow I will beat him. Now I have more knowledge. Now we learn for that, this is bad. Also, يباهي به العلماء. Okay, you have a good scholars. Also, us, we have a good scholar. Look, we have Sheikh Muhammad Dana, like that. This is also bad intention. If our intention to learn for that, this is bad. يباهي به العلماء أو يماري به السفهاء أو يقبل به وجوه الناس إليه. To make the people see him, huh? To make them note me. Look, it's like this. He don't see this, but he's talking, and mashallah, they enjoy to make them, oh, mashallah, Sheikh Hasan, mashallah, Sheikh, mashallah, Sheikh Hasan, he see said, Sheikh Hasan, astaghfirullah. This is 100% if Hasan, his intention like this, 100%. He will go to hell because Allah, he want this class for him. He want you to listen for him, to write for him. Why you came to here? For him. This is Allah. Also, the fourth reason, لِيَأْخُذْ بِهِ الْأَمْوَالَ مِنَ الْأُمَرَى. يَأْخُذْ بِهِ الْأَمْوَالَ. He want to gain more money from the princes, from the ministers, from the presidents. He want to improve his life. I will have a PhD. After PhD, I will gain monthly at least 10,000 ringgit. What I will do for this 10,000 ringgit? I will buy a good house, a good car, a good phone. Allah Akbar, another woman. Just think about dunya. Astaghfirullah. He didn't at the same time say, inshallah, 10% from that daily, monthly, I will give for poorness, for poor people, to help my poor people in my family. To like that. He mixed with a good intention. But all things he only focused in. يأخذ به الأموال من الأمراء. He want only money from this knowledge. This is no. So the importance of the niyyah. When I heard from one scholar, he said, one person he mashallah, he was salihin, from salihin, one good person. He's wali min al awliya, mashallah. He's beside him ordinary person. This ordinary person, he opened the window. He opened the window. So he asked him, why did you open the window? He said, I want to smell a good air, and clean air, and refresh the air inside the room. So this wali or salih, he said, can you please don't say this. Don't say this. He said, what I should say? He said, "You it's better for you to say, I will open the window to hear the adhan. To hear what? The adhan. And the air will come automatically. Don't think about things will come automatically. Don't make your niyyah your rizq. You will have what your rizq. Don't make your niyyah, I will gain money. You will have money. Allah, I want, until this age, did Allah lost you? How he take care about you and you are inside your mother without any money, without any food. Subhanallah. How many reasons Allah he have to take care about this human being? But this human being, he, because his intention take care about his brothers, because his intention is not correct, take care about his intention, Allah he don't open his mind to realize what around him. Also, Allahu Akbar, there was a story in, to see the important of the important of the niyyah, of the intention. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Inshallah, and we, it's there was a king, This king, he was hunting with some of his princes and some of his ministers and some of his soldiers. With him was hunting, and in Arab we say fil badia, hunting after bear, bears, and so. And suddenly he feel Thursday, and he saw a good plant, mazra plant, rumman, and
pomegranate.
So he saw a pomegranate, and it was mashallah good. So he went to the garden. He asked him to give him a cup of juice of pomegranate. After he mixed it, so he said, "Okay, you're welcome." So he give him a cup of pomegranate, and he drink, and he feel it tasty. He like it very much. So he asked him, mashallah, you have a good mashallah pomegranate, and you have a good. How many taxes they take from you, the government? How many taxes? So he said, the gardener said, alhamdulillah. The owner, he said, alhamdulillah. Our king, he don't take a lot from us. We have a good king. He said like that. So the king, at the same time, he changed his niyyah, his intention. When he came back, he will issue a new order to increase the tax, to increase the tax. So he said, inside him, he didn't talk to anyone, just inside him. And he demand from him another glass, another cup. So he give him another cup, but he didn't taste the same thing. He told him, why did you change from another tree? Why didn't you give me from the same tree? He said, this, from the same tree I give you. So he said, why from the same tree? And it's not the same tasty. Subhanallah, the owner, he said direct, maybe our king, he changed his niyyah with his people. He said like that, maybe our king, he changed his niyyah, his intention with his people. So he did istighfar dalik. I will see he's correct or not. He's right or he just like. So give me from the same tree, give me another cup. And he changed his niyat, and when he came back, he won't issue any order. He leave the same tax, he won't increase. So he give him another cup, and when he drink from the same tree, the same tasty was before he taste. This is the power of the niyyah, brothers. This, you know, it's not easy, the niyyah. You know that person, he killed 99 person, and he also killed one scholar, and he finished 100 by one scholar. He don't have a wisdom or hikmah. He don't have a good way to answer the people. So because he didn't do one rak'ah, he didn't do one umrah or one hajj, he didn't do one fasting day, didn't do any worship, Just niyyah, he have a niyyah, change. And he went with a good niyyah, he want to change, he want to be good with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just he died with that niyyah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him. This is the power of the niyyah. Huh? This is the niyyah is, it's like the heart inside the body. This is the niyyah for the actions. If our niyyah correct, our actions automatically what will happen to the our actions automatically will be more correct. Even if you our actions there is some it's not complete with sunnah or adab, don't worry, just take care about your niyyah. Allah will complete that by time. What also scholars I heard from them, they said three things Allah, we can control three things inside us. Three things. Other things, this is from Allah, not from us. Allah, He give us permission to control three things inside us. Our niyyah. Second thing, brothers, Allah Akbar. Our dua. Third thing, brothers, النية والدعاء الله أكبر نية ودعاء واللهم صل وسلم على حبيب محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الله أكبر يا الله ذكرنا يا الله our فكر this is what we can our فكر our thinking your think what's inside your mind you control that what came inside this is depend on you intention, this is depend on you. Good intention, bad intention, this is depend on you. Dua, you can do good dua, you can do bad dua like Bal'oom. Alayhi la'natullah. He did. He was a big scholar and he feel himself against one prophet, Sayyidina Musa, and he did dua against Sayyidina Musa. You can do good dua, you can do bad dua. This is depend on you. If these three things is, you have a good dua, you have a good intention, you have a good fikr, Allah will take care about the rest. This is not. All books of the scholars, they start talk about intention. All the books of the scholars, maybe all the books. Inshallah. وإنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى مولانا شيخ محمد يحتاج نتكلم بالسند هنا عندي الكتاب بالسند أخبرنا ها طيب أخبرنا شيخنا الإمام الحافظ أبو البقاء خالد بن يوسف ابن سعيد بن الحسن ابن المفرج بن بكار المقدسي النابلسي الشافعي رضي الله عنه قال أخبرنا أبو اليمن الكندي أخبرنا محمد بن عبد الباقي الأنصاري أخبرنا أبو محمد الحسن بن علي الجوهري أخبرنا أبو الحسين محمد بن مظفر الحافظ أخبرنا أبو بكر بن محمد بن سليمان الواسطي حدثنا أبو نعيم عبد بن هشام الحلبي عن ابن المبارك عن يحيى بن سعيد عن محمد بن إبراهيم التيمي عن علقمة بن وقاص الليثي عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه ورضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته إلى دنيا يصيبها أو امرأة يتزوجها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه هذا حديث متفق على صحته مجمع على عظم موقعه وجلالته وهو أحد قواعد الإيمان وأول دعائمه وأشد الأركان وهو حديث فرد غريب باعتبار مشهور باعتبار آخر ومداره على يحيى بن سعيد الأنصاري قال الحافظ لا يصح هذا الحديث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم إلا من جهة عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه ولا عن عمر إلا من جهة علقمة ولا عن علقمة إلا من جهة إبراهيم بن محمد التيمي ولا عن محمد إلا من جهة يحيى بن سعيد وعن يحيى انتشرت روايته عن أكثر من 200 إنسان أكثرهم أئمة ورواه الإمام أبو عبد الله بن محمد أبو عبد الله محمد بن إسماعيل البخاري رحمه الله في صحيحه في سبعة مواضع فرواه في أول كتابه ثم في الإيمان ثم في النكاح ثم في العتق ثم في الهجرة ثم في ترك الحيل ثم في النذر ثم إن هذا الحديث روي في الصحيح بألفاظ إنما الأعمال بالنيات إنما الأعمال بالنية وأما الذي وقع في أول كتاب الشهاب الأعمال بالنيات وحذف إنما فقال الحافظ أبو موسى الأصبهاني لا يصح إسناد هذا.
Our Shaykh Abu al-Baqa al-Shafi'i, may Allah be pleased with him, related to us from Abu al-Yaman al-Kindi, from Muhammad al-Ansari, from Abu Muhammad Ali al-Jawhari, from Abu al-Husayn al-Muzaffar, from Abu Bakr al-Wasiti, from Abu Nu'aym Abd ibn Hisham al-Halabi, ibn al-Mubarak, from Yahya ibn Sa'id, from Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Taymi, from Alqama ibn Waqas al-Laythi, that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed, actions only go by intentions. Everyone gets what they intended. Anyone, therefore, who immigrates for Allah and His Messenger, then his immigration is indeed for Allah and His Messenger. But anyone who immigrates to gain something of this world or to marry a woman, his immigration is for that which he immigrated for. This hadith is unanimously agreed to be sound. Its position is immense and sublime. It is one of the foundations of belief, its first pillar and its strongest support. It is a unique and precious hadith, as is well known. Its backbone is Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari. As Shafi'i said, this hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is only sound by virtue of its having come by the way of Alqama, and only sound by virtue of having come from Alqama by the way of Yahya ibn Sa'id. From Yahya, the transmission of it spreads out to more than 200 men, most of whom are imams. Imam al-Bukhari related in his Sahih in seven places. He related it at the beginning of his book, and in the chapters on belief, marriage, freeing slaves, immigration, giving up deception, and oaths. This hadith is related in the Sahih in various ways. Indeed, actions only go by intentions, and indeed action is only by the intention. At the beginning of the book of Shihab, it reads, actions are by intentions and it does not include the word indeed. However, Abu Musa al-Sfahani said that the isnad of this transmission for this version is not sound.
This hadith mentioned by Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. A person, he's in Islam, his number 38. Islam maybe 38, but the scholars they said because his intention was very high, like his sincerity was very high with Allah, he became the second one in Islam. You see the power of the intention, brothers. Rasulullah also, he said, if there is prophet after me, who will be? Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu anhu. And one person, Umar, he wasn't Muslim, and he heard that Umar in Mecca, one person he heard that Umar, he was Muslim. This person, he was Muslim, so he was hearing that Umar, maybe he will be Muslim, and he said, this Muslim, he said, Umar will be Muslim, the donkey maybe will be Muslim, but Umar not will be Muslim. And that person, after years, he converted to Christian in Habasha. When they did the Hijrah, he was with them to Habasha. And he converted from Islam to Nasara. And he died Christian. Scholars, they said, because Sukhriya, Sheikh?
Sarcasm,
when we don't take care about our words to our other Muslim, we just talk, but Allah, He account all words. Maybe one word we don't take care about, that it will do for us a lot of problems. Sayyidina Al Hasan Al Basri, rahimahullah, he said, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, He forbid me. حرمني. الله سبحانه وتعالى حرمني من الله سبحانه وتعالى حرمني من قيام الليل ستة أشهر بسبب غيبة اختبتها في داخلي لأحد المسلمين ما تفوه بها ما تف... Allah, he didn't give me permission for tahajjud 6 months. I want to do tahajjud, but no permission. No permission. For 6 months. Because one day I did ghiba. All of us know what ghiba. Ghiba inside me too. Inside. I didn't mention, he didn't say anything. Inside him to
a Muslim.
To a Muslim.
He felt bad about the Muslim.
Allahu Akbar. Brothers, so this is Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, and you can see the greatness of the knowledge he mentioned by the la yasuhu hadha al-hadith an al-nabi illa min jihat Umar. This is the greatness of the knowledge. He reached to this knowledge until he analyzes the ways to the correct hadith, and there is many ways. This is, mashallah, how many knowledge inside, mashallah, how many, until he said, from this always to of this hadith, there is many ruwayah from this, and from
chains.
Here.
Chains.
All these chains, many chains, no correct chains, only from Umar bin al-Khattab, and no correct from Umar, from you until the end, Alqama, then Ibrahim, then this is the greatness of the knowledge, brothers. And who is this Bukhari, Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah, Allahu Akbar. And one dream, one of scholars in his time, he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after Bukhari passed away. So he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was doing classes about fiqh. So Rasulullah, he told him, Rasulullah, his name, Shaykh Abi Zayd al-Marwazi min Ashab al-Shafi'iyya. Ashab was a big scholar, and he was teaching fiqh. So he saw Rasulullah in his dream. Why didn't you take care about my book? So he asked him, Rasulullah, what's your book? He said, book Sahih al-Bukhari. My book is Sahih al-Bukhari. What's the secret? Everyone have a secret, we said. From the Everyone must have secret, brothers. Every one of us must have secret between him and what his secret? He said, Imam Bukhari, I didn't put one hadith until I do wudu and do 2 rak'ah. I didn't put one hadith. All how many hadith in Sahih Bukhari?
7,000
plus. Multiply.
Multiply
2 rak'ah, around 14,000 rak'ah for Sahih Bukhari. Allah Akbar. He didn't only write and finish. No. Also, Imam Nawawi, also some scholars, they mentioned, he said, I didn't write Riyadh al-Salihin. Once time, I didn't write once, until I take a shower and do 2 rak'ah. Then I write Riyadh al-Salihin.
Each hadith.
Imam Nawawi, every Riyadh al-Salihin. Yes, also, he said also, illa akhtasaltu. إِلَّا اخْتَسَلْتُ. Also Imam Bukhari also. He also was taking for every hadith, brothers. For 7,000 ghusl. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This is... how... where is this power came from? Good actions or good intention? So this is the meaning of the intention, brothers. This is the power. The secret, all the secret is first of all where? The attention, brothers. And also this is, adabuhu ma'al hadith is one of etiquette of Imam Bukhari with hadith. Now I will write hadith of Rasulullah. And I should write it by and I'm by good good what in Arabic we say في أفضل وضع أكون فيه.
The best of states.
The best of states, huh? I should write it of the best of states. What's your best of states, Imam Bukhari? Taking shower every time. Taking shower for every hadith. Sayyidina Imam Nawawi, every time he writes Riyad al-Salihin. But Imam Bukhari, every time he writes hadith. Also, I heard from scholars, and he collects for every
chapter.
For every chapter, he collects many ahadith. Many? Ahadith, and from those ahadith, he was doing istikhara for every hadith. Ya Allah, should I put this hadith or not? Also, I heard from scholars, many actions with Allah until Allah accept his. And now, Sahih Bukhari is the best book after Quran. Every hadith. In this many hadith we mentioned in this majlis, in this circle, the rewards also go to him. He is now in his grave. Allahu Akbar. What this greatness, brothers? Huh? Allahu Akbar. This is we say mulk. ما هذا الملك عربي في العربي نقول ما هذا الملك ما هذا الملك. Also, I think, brother, it's the end. Okay. طيب إن شاء الله. وأما معنى النية فهو القصد وهو عزم القلب وإنما لفظ موضوعه للحصر لفظة موضوعة للحصر تثبت المذكور وتنفي ما عداه. فمعنى الحديث لا تصح الأعمال الشرعية إلا بالنية ومن قصد بهجرته رضا الله تعالى ومن قصد بها الدنيا فهي حظه ليس له غيرها. وفي هذا الحديث اشتراط النية في الوضوء وغيره والغسل والتيمم والصلاة والزكاة والصوم والاعتكاف والحج وغيرها. وقال إمامنا أبو عبد الله بن محمد بن إدريس الشافعي رضي الله تعالى عنه يدخل هذا الحديث في 70 بابا من الفقه. وقال أيضا يدخل في هذا الحديث ثلث العلم. وقال عبد الله أحمد بن حنبل رضي الله تعالى عنه يدخل فيه ثلث العلم. وكذا ذكره أيضا غيرهما. قال الإمام الحافظ أبو بكر البيهقي في أول كتابه مختصر السنن معنى قول الشافعي رضي الله تعالى عنه يدخل فيه ثلث العلم أن كسب العبد إنما يكون بقلبه ولسانه ونياته وجوارحه. والنية أحد أقسام كسبه وهي أرجحها لأنها تكون عبادة بانفرادها بخلاف القسمين الآخرين لأن القول والعمل يدخلهما الفساد بالرياء ولا يدخل النية.
أوكي. الأغلب يفهم عربي.
الله أكبر. إن شاء الله. All what mentioned here, they want us to realize the importance of the intention, the greatness of the intention. And as we said, brothers, the intention have a power. Allah, he mentioned in Quran, he said, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ. قَدْ نَرَى. Allah, he mentioned some things inside Rasulullah. Inside Rasulullah. And he said, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. Rasulullah, nobody knows what's inside him. This is Allah, he see you now. Now he see your intention. Now, you see. So scholars, beginning of the action, any action, they renew, they take care about the intention. Inside that action, they also renew the same niya. After they finish that action, also they refresh the niya. What was at the beginning my niya? They don't change it until Allah accepts that action. So Sayyidina Al-Imam Shafi'i, MashaAllah, Imam Shafi'i, the knowledge of him, he relies direct. This hadith, it take care about 70 chapter of fiqh, this hadith. Also, there is some tabi'een, he said, in one action, I put 70 niyyah. In one action, he put, I went from this action, Allah, he loved me, and Rasulullah loved me, and I went from this action to get more knowledge for deen, and I went for this action to, he's like that, accounting, until he reached to 70 intention. Until he reached to 70 intention. And we start Dawrah, the end of the Dawrah, everyone, he will get a rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All these rewards depend on our intention. What your intention, you want good rewards, take care about. So some scholars, he spent all the night to correct one intention. And he think about, is that intention is for Allah? And he do two rak'ah, and he cry, Ya Allah, accept it from me that. They realize what the important of the intention, brothers. Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab, he said, لا احتساب بلا بلا نية. Who do any action without niyyah, this action, Allah, he don't see to this action. They won't put your action in your measured in that judgment day. So if you want all your actions put in your measured, and your measured be heavy,
scale
in your scale in that day, take care about the intention in every try, practice. We did before some minutes, Salatul Asr. What your niyyah? Just routine. Alhamdulillah, now time Asr. Okay, Allah, He will reward you. There is a reward, but the reward will increase by good intention. And the best intention, all scholars, they said, how Allah, He loved me. He how I gain Ridha'ullah. How I gain this Ridha'ullah?
Satisfaction
of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the best. No niyyah like this niyyah. Inshallah, brothers, we. Okay. So, brothers, also, there is, inshallah, no problem in the story. Okay. Today I'm saying like that. From tomorrow, inshallah. Okay. Bismillah, a'udhu billah, bismillah. So, also, استحب العلماء رضي الله تعالى عنهم أن تستفتح المصنفات بهذا الحديث وممن ابتدى به في أول كتابه الإمام أبو عبد الله البخاري رحمه الله في أول حديثه في صحيحه الذي هو أصح الكتب بعد كتاب الله تعالى. وروينا عن الإمام أبي سعيد عبد الرحمن بن مهدي رحمه الله قال لو صنفت كتابا بدأت في أول كل باب منه بهذا الحديث. وروينا عن الإمام سليمان أبي سليمان أحمد بن محمد بن إبراهيم الخطابي رحمه الله فيما قرأته في أول كتابه الأعلام في شرح صحيح البخاري قال كان المتقدمون من شيوخنا يستحبون تقديم حديث الأعمال بالنية أمام كل شيء ينشأ ويبتدئ من أمور الدين لعموم الحاجة إليه في جميع أنواعها. وبلغنا عن جماعات من السلف رضي الله تعالى عنهم أشياء كثيرة من نحو هذا من الاهتمام بهذا الحديث والله أعلم. وهي أن إسناده شيء يستحسن ويستغرب عند المحدثين، وهي أن رواته اجتمع فيهم ثلاثة تابعيون يروي بعضهم عن بعض وهم يحيى بن سعيد الأنصاري ومحمد بن إبراهيم التيمي وعلقمة بن وقاص وهذا وإن كان مستظرفا فهو كثير في الأحاديث المستظرفة الصحيحة يجتمع ثلاثة تابعيون بعضهم عن وأربعة تابعيون بعضهم عن بعض وقد جمعها الحافظ عبد القادر الرهاوي رحمه الله في جزء صنفه فيها وأنا أرويها وقد اختصرتها في أول شرح صحيح البخاري رحمه الله وضممت إليها ما وجدته مثلها فبلغ مجموعها زيادة على 30 حديثا والله أعلم إضافة الفائدة إلى قائلها ومما ينبغي الاعتناء به بيان الأحاديث التي قيل أنها أصول الإسلام وأصول الدين أو عليها مدار الإسلام أو مدار الفقه والعلم فنذكرها في هذا الموضوع لأن أحدها حديث الأعمال بالنية ولأنها مهمة فينبغي أن تقدم وقد اختلف العلماء في عددها اختلافا كثيرا وقد اجتهد في جمعها وتبيينها الشيخ الإمام الحافظ أبو عمرو عثمان بن عبد الرحمن المعروف بابن الصلاح رحمه الله تعالى ولا مزيد على تحقيقه واتقانه فأنا أنقل ما ذكره رحمه الله مختصرا وأضم إليه ما تيسر مما لم يذكره فإن الدين النصيحة ومن النصيحة أن تضاف الفائدة التي تستغرب إلى قائلة فمن فعل ذلك بورك له في عمله وحاله ومن أوهم ذلك وأوهم فيما يأخذه من كلام غيره أنه له فهو جدير أن لا ينتفع بعلمه ولا يبارك له في حاله ولم يزل أهل العلم والفضل على إضافة الفوائد إلى قائلها نسأل الله تعالى التوفيق لذلك دائما قال الشيخ أبو عمرو
ترجم شوي
عمرو رحمه الله بعد أن حكم أقوال الأئمة في تعيين الأحاديث التي عليها مدار الإسلام واختلافهم في عيانها وعددها فبلغت 26 حديثا أحدها حديث إنما الأعمال بالنيات Brothers, they mentioned here the actions of every Muslim and his words accepted depend on his knee as his intention. So they said four things is signs. Signs, four things: the heart, the jawarih,
limbs,
huh?
Limbs,
huh? The heart, his jawarih,
limbs,
his heart, his limbs, and his intention and his tongue, and this is Allah. This is very because it's a pair things. From this four things, so we always take care about what inside in our hearts. Take care about what we will say. Take care about what we will do actions, and take care about our intention. So he said the heart and the tongue and the intention and the lips. The important thing is the niyyah, and as we say, how Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned what he was thinking inside. In Rasulullah time, the Qibla was to Masjid al-Aqsa, and Rasulullah, subhanallah, when he do worship and do salah, inside him, he wish that the Qibla to the Kaaba, to Mecca. So by time, this is, you know, by time thinking, this appear. Allah, he said, in the sama, nara, taqalluba wajhika fi sama. Your intention, this intention, you want to the Qibla to Mecca. It shows, it's like a projector. You know the projector? It came from inside you, this intention, until we see it in the sky. The sky, it became a screen, big screen, Allah. قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Okay. So فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَهَا. Okay, Muhammad, Now, you pray to Kaaba, and there is one masjid called Al Qiblatain in Medina. They was praying, I think, Asr time, and somebody was moving near, walking near to the to that masjid, and they was praying to Masjid Aqsa, and he told them, or a new order came to pray to Mecca, so they change at the same salah. So that it's they do the same salah. They do two ways. To Mecca, they do Salatul Asr two directions. To Masjid al-Aqsa, and the same salah also they pray it to Mecca. They name it Masjid al-Qiblatain. This is cause the power of the attention, brothers. Yes, also. أيضا شيخ محمد هذا من 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 علامات العلماء الربانيين. Also this is also signs of those good scholars we say in Arabic العلماء الربانيين the best scholars. This is the mean رباني the best
God fearing scholars.
God fearing scholars. Though they have a signs. They mentioned the hadith to who deserve who work a lot who so he said a tabi'in three percent tabi'in all those tabi'in mashallah they are no problem with them in the measure of a hadith no problem with them so he didn't say me or the good scholar he
always references
yes
the good scholar
yes
the God-fearing scholar always references and quotes the source of his knowledge unlike scholars of today who make quotations and they ascribe their name to that quotation when in reality that was a quotation of someone else that they dug up from the books and took from someone else and just put their name. But the real scholars and the true scholars, and as the ulama have said, such as Imam al-Qurtubi rahimullah, that from the barakah of ilm, from the blessing or from the blessing of knowledge and the blessed fruits of knowledge, is that you ascribe the quotes to who they belong. Okay. So Imam al-Nawawi rahimullah, he mentioned about this in his Bustaan, yani, in his work here, that the ulama should do this, the scholars should do this.
They must have this etiquette. Inshallah, we learn from them. Inshallah, we introduce the others more better than when we introduce ourselves. Inshallah.
And then that's coming back to a very important point in terms of ikhlas, because and that's why he mentions it here when he's talking about ikhlas, because the reality is the ulama rabbaniyin, the pious scholars, they call to Allah, to Rabb. Yani they call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why they're called the ulama rabbaniyin. But then you have scholars who call to their greatness, okay? Who to call to having their Facebook following or their YouTube hits, okay? And so what they do, those scholars are people who speak knowledge, okay? And what are we? In reality, a scholar is nothing but a vessel of knowledge. A vessel or a vehicle of knowledge that he took from someone before him, who took from someone before him, going back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But nowadays, what we find people who try to present knowledge as if they are the owners of that knowledge, and they are the people who brought that knowledge to us through, as if there was some revelation that came to them. But the reality is,
they discovered it.
Yeah, as if they discovered it. But the reality is that it comes from someone else, but they are not willing to ascribe it to that person because of a lack of ikhlas, a lack of sincerity. You see, and that's how Imam, that, and that's why Imam, you know, to go deep into why he brings it here at this point in Bustaan al-Arifeen. Allah Ta'ala alam.
Allah Ta'ala alam. نسأل الله ينفعنا بما علمنا ويعلمنا الذي ينفعنا ويزيدنا علما نافعا ويفتح علينا علوما من عارفين إن شاء الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وصحبه من والاه. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا غاية رغبتنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا ربي قد اجتمعنا لتدارس أحاديث حبيبك ولتدارس مجالس علمي يا أرحم الراحمين وقصدنا بها وجهك يا أرحم الراحمين. فارض عنا وعن الحاضرين ومنهم من أتى من أماكن بعيدة وأنفق أموال كثيرة يا أرحم الراحمين ليجتمع مع العلماء ويجتمع مع المشايخ هنا يا أرحم الراحمين. ونحن كلنا يا ربي فقراء ضعفاء محتاجين إليك يا مولانا. فارض عنا وعنهم يا أرحم الراحمين وتقبل منا هذا العمل خالصا لوجهك الكريم وتقبل منا هذه المجالس وكل مجالس في هذه الدورة خالصة لوجهك الكريم وتقبل هذه الدورة يا أرحم الراحمين خالصة لوجهك الكريم واجعلها لنا ذخرا في الدنيا وفي الآخرة تنفعنا في دنيانا وفي قبرنا وعند موتنا وفي حشرنا وفي آخرتنا يا أرحم الراحمين وتزيد رضاك يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين تزيد رضاك عنا. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.